There's Dupria. And the first big hit, and it's on the big fella, Victor Matfield. In goes Jacques Ferry. John Smith, early touch for the captain. He's got the support there of Skulpberger. There's Burgess. Cooper. Ioane at speed. Great step. Try. There's Iongi. Bit of space. Surrounded though by black jerseys. Taken by McCaw and also Kahui. And they've turned it again. And now there's a chance. Williams. Nonu. Look at Dag tracking on the inside. It's Toeava. Toeava, can he find the offload of Williams? He can to Dag, and Dag gets a second. Picked up by Tuolangi, bit of space here for Mele. Mele out to Plante, Plante for the corner, try for Perpignan. The tide has turned, the pickup at the base, good work, good hands from David Mele, and Plante, who's a very speedy finisher indeed. Advantage being played. The Saracens out, pops cut, Skull Brits again, then the offload to De Kock for the try line, he reaches out, and Bruce Falls in the perfect spot, that will be referred. Another drive, edging another 3 metres closer, that was Kerr to Robson. Kerr again, trying to go wide, Clegg, Brown, out to Monier, and the drought is over for Hugo Monier, the man who made his Harlequins debut against Wasps a decade ago, and that his ninth premiership try against the Wasps club. There he is, Nangusa, the little chip ahead, he's the real flyer on the pitch, Nangusa for the line! What a story! Tomasi Nangusa, the top try scorer for Montpellier in the top 14 this season. Yashvili back to Parra. Oh, and it's back off the upright. Oh, and Pickamall is through, but the ball went forward. The referee playing advantage. Chance to break here for Nonu. Surely the quickest man on the field. He's straight to Matanamu. And look at the pace from the wing. It's a brilliant individual effort. Superb. Now those were the movements of a pure classic sprinter. You could have been watching an Olympic 100 metre final there.
This time cleanly away, and Bolt is already past the youngster Edward. Bolt is going for it here, Mullings is coming off the bend fast, but it's all here about Usain Bolt. Sean Crawford on the outside is having a good run. He's 4 metres, 5 metres, 6 metres away. Bolt against the clock. 19.20. It is a world record by a tenth of a second. 11 one-hundredths in the 100, 1/10 in the 200. And as Tim was saying before the final, if anything, this was a tougher record to break.
And this woman, well, what is there left to say? Apart from, here she is going at what would be a 24th world record in her career. It would also be her fourth of the year. It's her third and final attempt at 5 metres and five. Can she go clear? Yes, she can! Yelena Essenbaeva. It's a full house. The Olympic gold, the Olympic record, and now a world record. Yet another one at these Olympic Games in track and field. Arugu though does have them in their sights, and Arugu does her best work in the second half. Sanya Richards has her first global prize in her sights. Kashina within sight of her, but she tends to suffer a little bit in the last 100. Arugu's starting to come through, but she's back in about fourth place at the moment. Richards into the straight, she's got a 3 metre lead, the American kicking on, but here comes Arugu for Great Britain. Can Arugu get there? I think she can. Gold for Christine Arugu. She's there, she's done it! 49.62! What a marvellous, marvellous run! And when, for Sanya Richards, the questions were asked, when the prize was within her sights, she started
losing the legs, and Kristi Norrugu, who was only in fourth place coming into the straight, well, she went into overdrive. The world champion is now the Olympic champion, and to think 18 months ago there was a bylaw in her way to prevent her coming here. That's been lifted, and now, well, she can't believe it. What a performance by the Britons.